When you're recording your audio or video, do you find yourself saying, and that kind of thing? Yeah, I think most people do. I know I was shocked to find out how much I use the and filler words, even though I'm consciously trying not to. Descript has a great feature called Filler Word Removal, which makes it super simple to get rid of all those ums, and a whole bunch of other filler words with just a couple of clicks. So let's take a look and see how that works.
At this point, we've already had Descript automatically transcribe our audio. And then we went through and reduced the big word gaps, the big pauses and dead air in our video. If you missed either of those, please feel free to go back and check out those videos. Now what we're going to do is we're going to get rid of filler words. We're inside of our project here. We're going to come up here to our little magic button, and we're going to say remove filler words. And we have some options here when it comes to the filler words. It's looking for and And we can drop that down. This will depend on which subscription tier you have with Descript. I believe the free and creator plans might only have The pro plan has something like 18 of these filler words. These are all things that we want to get rid of. I don't know about you, but I have noticed that I use a lot more than I ever thought I did. And so is another one that I never really realized until I started using Descript that I start sentences a lot of times with so, and it's just unnecessary. Something else that'll get rid of for us is repeated words. I've certainly found in my videos that I do that. So we'll let it look at and get rid of every one of these things that it sees right here. If there's something you don't want it to get rid of, maybe there's a reason you need some of these words to stay in there, particularly if you're quoting something or one of these words or phrases is really an important part of your context. I'm going to leave all of them checked, let it get rid of everything. It's found 19 results in one composition. And over here on the right, it will show you everywhere it found those things. For instance, here, this is a repeat word. There are some. It'll get rid of that. I did the same thing down here again. I repeated the word. It's finding the the wells, the right, and you know, this is in here because it's a repeated word. This is a repeated phrase that it found. Repeated phrase again, and another well. You can either remove those, just cut them out. This is going to trim it out of the audio, and it'll trim that video section out too. If for some reason you don't want that to happen, you can say, replace with gap clip. That'll replace the filler words with no audio whatsoever, but be a placeholder in the timeline. So for us, I'm going to remove it. Another setting you have here is you can either completely delete those filler words, take them out altogether, or you can use ignore, which will strike through them up here in the text panel, and it'll take them out down here in the timeline. If you're not really sure, and you might want to put some of these back in, if you use this ignore option and just have it strike through, you'll still see those up here in your scripts. As you're going through and editing, you can decide, and if you want to bring them back, it's very easy to just select it and remove the ignore marker. Just select it and then take off the ignore option. For me, I'm going to get rid of them altogether. So we're just going to say apply to all. And boom, just like that, we've gotten rid of all of our and ahs and duplicate words.
Sometimes when it removes an or an or one of these filler words, there might be just a slight jumpiness or a chop where the edit could have been made in a little bit better place. It's just taking out the or the and it's doing a really good job of finding it and getting rid of it. But sometimes a human touch is needed to make it that much better. So let's take a look at how we can do that.
Everywhere you see a line down here where you see the video has been split, every one of these splits is representing somewhere that we either shortened a word gap and so it cut out a blank space, or somewhere that we removed a filler word and it cut that word out. Now we have the two separate clips. So if there's a place that I need to make an edit here, you just come down here on the timeline, hover my mouse over this split, and then notice if the bracket is pointing to the right, that means I would be extending or dragging in the clip that's to the right. If my bracket is to the left, and you get this just by moving it slightly right or left, if my bracket is to the left, notice that the open part of this bracket is to the left. That means that if I click and drag, I'm working with the clip that's to the left. So I would be either expanding or reducing. If I pull this to the right, I can bring that back in if I want it to be back in. I don't really want it to be back in, so I'll do that. This one here, the open part of the bracket is to the right, so I can just click, drag to the left. I can bring back that and that space. I've got a spot down here that just doesn't sound very good. And there's some editor. You notice there where between there's some, it says there's some. there's some editor. We're going to go click on this. We've got our open bracket to the right, so that we'll be working with the clip to the right. We're going to click and we're going to drag. And see, we have the word sum there. Descript took out the sum, but it didn't exactly nail where it was. We're going to drag that back closed. And I suspect what's happening is, by looking at the waveform, this particular sum should have stopped there. Now let's see if we can zoom this in a little bit and make it clearer to see. We can do that by hitting these three dots on the right side above the timeline and zoom in, or we can click the control key and the equal symbol on the keyboard above the letters. So we're gonna do that a few times and we can really hone in on that waveform. And aha, I think we see. And there's some, I think it's right about here. So we're going to grab this. We're going to bring it back to that particular spot and see if that sounds better. And there's some editors that that's a little better. And there's some editors that that's how we can fine tune after we've used a script filler word removal. The next thing we're going to do with this video is we're going to ignore part of the script. We're going to edit this script a little bit more. We're going to tell the script what we want it to ignore so that we can clean up our script. I hope you'll stick with me for that. Just click the video on the right hand side of your screen there and we'll get going. If you don't have Descript yet, you can try it for free. There's a link in the description, and you can stay on the free tier as long as you like, so you can really play around with it and see if it works for you. Full disclosure, I may receive a commission at no extra cost to you if you use my link.